There are two folds of my research. The first one is the brain mechanisms of movement stopping. And another aspect is how the brain region responsible for movement stopping is related to cognitive functioning. That was kind of motivated from my grandfather, because as he was suffering from Parkinson's disease, along with all those motoric impairments, he also suffered from Alzheimer's and cognitive decline and stuff like that. And the other thing, it's kind of related to my daughter who suffers from the myotonic muscular dystrophy. This is a very rare neuromuscular disease that progresses throughout the entire life. That leads to potential delays in cognitive milestones. That also highly motivated me about studying this relationship between the motor and cognitive functioning. I'm developing a novel research technique in order to better investigate Parkinson's patients' brain responses. I initially started that work with a healthy participant, and then I started moving on to the Parkinson's patients because we developed a new technique that we could wirelessly measure deep brain activity using the existing deep brain stimulation device that is typically placed in a brain region called subthalamic nucleus in the Parkinson's patient's brains. STN has been known for its primary role in being responsible for stopping movements, and it's been a primary target of the DBS placement because one of the Parkinson's symptoms is the hand shaking and leg shaking. It's called tremors. With the placement of the DBS at the STN, and when the DBS starts generating electrical pulses to change the functioning of the STN, then it would stop Parkinson's patients' hand shaking, and it also stops their rigid movement. I kind of got spoiled by the level of science that we're doing here. So that's all because of the great infrastructures that we have here and the great collaborative environment. For example, Dr. Greenlee, who's actually operating the neurosurgery to place that DBS device into the Parkinson's patients. And we also work with neurologists at the Department of Neurology in the University Bio Hospital. That's one of the reasons I chose to stay here, because it's a great opportunity for me to proceed with other projects that will actually matter in the field that I belong to.